Hello friends, welcome for the another problem on the dynamic analysis. So here we have the question. Determine the eigenvalues and the frequency for a stepped bar shown in figure. So it is a stepped bar having one end is fixed and the displacement at each nodes u1, u2, u3 and the area for the element 1 that is 1 meter square, for element 2 that is 0.5 meter square, and this is the length for the element 1 10 meter and L2 is 5 meter, and the Young's modulus that is 30 into 10 power of 10 Newton per meter square is the Young's modulus for both the material, that is E1 and E2, and the specific weight that is 8500 kg per meter cube. So the specific weight, or you can say the density of the material, is 8500 kg per meter cube is given for the both the materials. For element 1 and for element 2. So first we will write all the given values. So A1 is 1 meter square, A2 is 0.5 meter square, and L1 is 10 meter, L2 is 5 meter. Next, E1 is 30 into 10 power of 10 Newton per meter square, and E2 is again same, 30 into 10 power of 10 Newton per meter square, and density or the specific weight, that is rho 1, is 8500 kg per meter cube, and rho 2 is 8500 kg per meter cube. So these are the given value for the both the element. So this dynamic analysis we can solve as similar to the eigenvalues problem. So in the eigenvalue problem, so we'll have A minus lambda into B matrix whole multiplication with X is equal to 0. So this is the general formula for to calculate the eigenvalues, where lambda, it will be the eigenvalue. So here the same concept, it will be applied to the dynamic problems in the finite elements method. So here the equation, it will be where K, it is the global stiffness matrix, minus and lambda minus omega square into the global mass matrix into the displacement, where X, it will be represented as a displacement, that is U is equal to 0. So this dynamic analysis, it can be solved using this equation. Okay, so first we have to calculate the global stiffness matrix, that is K, by adding the A1 plus A2, and after that we will calculate the mass matrix for the element 1 and element 2, then these two to be added and you will get the mass matrix, where U will be the displacement, that is U1, U2, U3 matrix. Okay, where this omega square, it will be a frequency of the stepped bar. So before calculating the frequency, you have to calculate the eigenvalue, that is lambda, you have to calculate. So you will get the two lambdas here for material 1 and material 2. Element 1. So for the stepped bar, as you know, where we will calculate K1 is for the element 1. So for stepped bar, it is A1 E1 by L1, again 1 into 1 matrix, sorry, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, so for the element 1, the nodes, it will be 1 to 2. So area is 1 meter, Young's modulus is 30 into 10 power of 10 divided by the length is 10 meter, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. Okay, so here we will get 3 into 10 power of 10, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. 1 2 1 2. So now we'll calculate the mass matrix, the element mass matrix, that is where M1 is equal to, for the stepped bar, the mass matrix equation is rho AL by 6. In the 2 into 2 matrix, it is 2, 1, 1, 2, it should be. Okay, now you can write rho 1, A1, L1 by 6. So substitute the value of rho, that is 8500 into area is 1 meter square, length is 10 meter, divided by 6, 2, 1, 1, 2. So after calculation, this it will becomes 85 into 10 power of 3 divided by 6, 2, 1, 1, 2. So again, you can represent the nodes 1, 2, 1, 2. So now we'll go for element 2. Similarly, we'll calculate for the element 2 also. For element 2. So there, K2 is equal to A2 E2 by L2. 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. And the nodes, it will be from 2 to 3. So here the nodes are like 1, 2, 3. So that is in basic steps we have not explained in this concept. So if you want, you can go for the problems on the stepped bar. There we will go for the detail about all the discretizing of elements. So now here we will substitute the value of A2, that is 0.5 into Young's modulus is same as E1, divided by the length for the element 2 is 5 meter. In bracket 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So we will get 3 into 10 power of 10 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So here you represent the nodes 2 3 2 3. So similarly, we will calculate the mass matrix, element mass matrix, that is M2. So same equation, rho 2 A2 by L2 divided by 6, 2 minus 1 minus 1, sorry, 2 1 1 2. So rho value is 8500, A2 is 0.5 into length is 5 meter divided by 6. 2 1 1 2. So 85 into 10 power of 3 into 24 will take 2 1 1 2. So here the nodes are 2 to 3, 2 to 3. Okay, so after that, the main thing is you have to calculate the global stiffness matrix. Global stiffness matrix. And also you have to calculate the global mass matrix. Okay, so first to calculate the global stiffness matrix, you have to add K1 plus K2. Where K is equal to K1 plus K2. So in K1 and K2, the common term is 3 into 10 power of 10. Okay, here also at the K1, 3 into 10 power of 10 is outside the matrix. So it is easier to make the addition of these two. So the elements, it will be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 in the global matrix. So here it is 1, 1, same. 1 minus 1, 1, 3, 0. Similarly, 2, 1. So 2, 1 is minus 1, and 2, 2 is 1 plus 1, that is 2. 2, 3 is minus 1. 2, 3, yes, that is minus 1. Now we'll go 3, 1 is 0, 3, 2 is minus 1, 3, 3 is 1. Okay. So this step also we have explained clearly in the bar elements. For one dimensional bar element, there you can go for detail about the adding the matrix. So now the mass matrix, again M1 and M2 you have to add here. So in the M1 and M2, the common term which you have taken as 85 into 10 power of 3 in divided by 24. If you make 24, then 85 into 10 power of 3 divided by 24. Eight, four, zero, four, ten, one, zero, one, two. So again, I am telling you, so this step you can follow in the first unit problems. So here the 1, 2, 3, because here we are concentrating some other concept instead of the basic steps. So we got K and M. So once you calculated the K and M, we have to substitute in the equation, in the damped vibration equation. This is called as undamped vibration equation. So now 3 into 10 power of 10. 1 minus 1, 0, minus 1, 2 minus 1, 0 minus 1, 1. This is as K minus now W square, omega square, that is. So omega square into the M matrix. So 85 into 10 power of 10. Sorry, 10 power of 3 divided by 24. 8, 4, 0, 4, 10, 1, 0, 1, 2. This is mass matrix into the displacement x or u is equal to 0 into, so we'll take the square matrix for whole the elements. Now into the displacement. Displacements are u1, u2, u3 is equal to 0. So now this is in the standard equation in this format. So now after this, we will divide 3 into 10 power of 10 throughout the equation. So it will be divided here also. So we want to element this one. Okay, so after dividing 3 into 10 power of 10 throughout the equation, so here this 3 into 10 power of 3, it will get cancelled, and whatever the value you have, that is 85 into 10 power of 3 divided by 24, that value will get as 1.181 into 10 power of minus 7 omega square, and the equation, the matrix, it will be remaining same. Okay, so here this value we will take as the lambda eigenvalue. So what that is 1.181 into 10 power of minus n omega square, it will be taken as lambda. So after taking the lambda, so we'll the having the remaining this matrix minus this is n lambda into the remaining matrix. So into multiplication is the displacement. So after that we will make the subtraction, this minus this. So 1 minus 8 lambda minus 1 minus 4 lambda. So we are taking the multiplication simultaneously. So 0 minus 0 lambda. So it becomes total 0. So let us take it is in the bracket. So now minus 1 minus 4 lambda, 2 minus 10 lambda, minus 1 minus lambda. So 0, 0, it is again same, minus 1 minus lambda, 1 minus 2 lambda into the displacement as u1, u2, u3 is equal to 0. So now, since the given stepped bar is fixed at node 1 and the displacement at will be 0, so u1 it will be 0, because at the node 1 we have fixed, so the displacement it will be taken as 0 for that boundary conditions. So after applying the boundary conditions, so this entire row and this entire column it will get cancelled, so remaining we'll have in the matrix 2 minus 10 lambda, 1 minus 1 minus lambda, minus 1 minus lambda, 2 minus, sorry, 1 minus 2 lambda is equal to, into u2 u3 is equal to 0. Find the non-zero values of circular frequency. They equate the determinants of coefficient matrix of equation to 0. So now we will make this equation in the determinant form. 2 minus 10 lambda, minus 1 minus lambda, minus 1 minus lambda, 1 minus 2 lambda is equal to 0. So we will solve this equation by taking the determinant. Wait, 2 minus 10 lambda into, so we have to make this multiplication first, after that minus into this multiplication, 1 minus 2 lambda, so minus of 1 minus 1 minus lambda, minus 1 minus lambda is equal to 0. So 2, first we'll make this 2 multiplication, after that we'll make this 2, so 2 minus 4 lambda, again minus 10 lambda plus 10 into 2, 20 lambda square. Again we'll come to this section, so first we'll take in the bracket, so minus 1 minus 1, that is plus 1 lambda, so that is again plus lambda, so again plus lambda, again plus lambda square is equal to 0. So here it is first 20 lambda square minus 14 lambda plus 2. So after we'll adding this basic mathematical operation, so now this minus will go inside, so minus 1 minus we'll add these two, so that is 2 lambda minus lambda square is equal to 0. So 20 minus 1 lambda, so we'll get 19 lambda square. So how many lambdas are there? 2, that is 14 and 2, so it is total minus 16 lambda. So now the constant value are 2 minus 1, so 2 minus 1 will get 1 is equal to 0. So this is a purely a quadratic equation. Okay, so by using the calculation, or you can go for the basic equation, that is where x is equal to minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So by using this equation we'll get the lambda value. Okay, so that lambda will have the sometimes a plus or minus, or sometimes the value is will be changed. So now from this equation I got the lambda value as 0.0679, and another value 0.0679, another value 0.7742. so these two value we'll get here, both are positive values. Okay, so these are the eigen values, so we can say lambda 1, so whichever the smallest one we'll take lambda 1 first. 0.0679 is the smallest one, we have to keep in the increasing order. And lambda 2 is 0.7742, it will be lambda 2. So these are the eigen values. Now we will calculate the frequencies, the eigenfrequencies, the frequency R. So we have taken here where lambda is equal to 1.181 into 10 power of minus 7 omega square is the considered value. So here we'll substitute this as lambda 1 first to calculate the natural frequency for omega 1. So here the lambda 1 is 0.0679 is equal to 1.181 into 10 power of minus 7 omega 1 square. So where omega 1 square is equal to 0.0679 divided by 1.181 into 10 power of minus 7. So that is equal to 0.6555 into 10 power of 7. So where omega 1 we got as 0.0575 into 10 power of 7. So omega 1 is equal to 57.5 into 10 power of 4 we will obtain. So second thing, we will calculate omega 2 also. There we will substitute 0.7742 as lambda 2 is equal to, again same equation, 1.181 into 10 power of minus 7 into omega 2 square. So omega 2 square is equal to 0.7747 divided by 1.81 into 10 power of minus 7 is equal to 0.6555 into 10 power of minus 7. So here the omega 2 final equation, it will be 2560.3. So this is a frequency we'll obtain, and the unit for the natural frequency, it is a radian per second, radian per second. So this is the solution for a stepped bar. So in the next class we are going to solve the dynamic analysis on the truss problem.